Hey everybody, what's up? Welcome to April's edition to the channel. Updates, news, and other things. Kind of had to laugh when I started doing this video because I feel like this is like my monthly magazine. Today we're going to play a little more of Unreal Tournament 3 Black Edition. This time around we're going to do some Capture Flag. 30-minute time, no capture limit. For those of you who don't know what capture flag is, there's two bases, two teams, two flags. Each team has to go to the enemy base, grab the flag, and return to their own. I wanted to welcome new people to the channel. We are officially at 10 subscribers. Woohoo, go us! Thank you for all your support. But for channel things, channel news, I should say, as we get ready to get into that before we start, we got two games going on currently right now. We got Far Cry 4 and XCOM Enemy Unknown. I kind of like put a pause on Far Cry 4 at the moment because if you guys have watched some of my episodes for that, I'm extremely frustrated with how crappy it looks on my computer for some odd reason. Like, I can play literally everything on ultra max settings and have no problem, but Far Cry 4 for some reason looks like complete and utter shit. But we are halfway through it and I ain't gonna cancel it. I am gonna continue doing it. I'm trying to figure out, fix the bugs, and why we're doing that. We're playing XCOM Enemy Unknown, sci-fi, turn-based strategy game. But let's just get into this fray and start this match, and we'll go over things as the match goes on. I am on the red team, I believe. Console, yeah. I'm on the red team, it's 6v6. That's going to be quite interesting. I bumped up the difficulty. Yes, again, I am playing with bots because everybody on my Steam does not have Unreal Tournament. I'm kind of a little bummed out about it. But, you know, I have no problem playing with bots.
Play. You are on red.
Thank you. Yeah, so Far Cry 4 isn't doing as well as I'd like to on visual-wise. Like, it's choppy and it's laggy in some spots, and there's a lot of hair if you pay attention to see the white lines through doors or whatnot. It's frustrating because, like, I just got Far Cry 4
under heavy attack
the last like few weeks, and I can play that in ultra with no issue.
Flag returned.
Okay, so that plan failed.
Red flag returned.
Yeah, it's very, very nerve-wracking. Like, it don't make no sense. But,
enemy flag carrier in the red base.
I'm gonna keep on messing with settings and try to get it look as best as possible.
Red flag returned.
I smoke these.
Yeah.
I've got our flag.
Red flag taken. Red flag returned.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna keep the bots defending our flag, and I'm just gonna go
flag taken.
The movie on for Far Cry 4, XCOM Enemy Unknown.
In position, all clear.
That let's play is going extremely well. I've added a lot of, like, I'm like horrible with like character names, especially with XCOM Enemy Unknown is one of those games that they've got pre-made characters with names, but like I always like put my friends and family members and people that I know in the game, just, you know, make it a little unique.
Red flag taken.
Stay down.
So far in XCOM we lost returned. Like four people. We lost Zach Miller,
red
he's a
flag,
friend of mine.
Red flag returned.
He was one of our support characters. He didn't do very well. He got killed off probably like mission 2 or 3. We just recently lost my roommate Gary Monty. He was a heavy, but for some odd reason the game doesn't really like me. He's giving me a bunch of snipers and a bunch of heavy units.
Killing spree.
So therefore, I'm like, I'm very low on assault characters, which is the post quarter shotgun user.
Oh.
Well, that was pretty close, but I'm really enjoying it. It's going a lot better than I thought it would be. The first time I played XCOM Enemy Unknown, before I started doing it on the channel, I was losing units left and right. It was like really ridiculous. Like they were really pushing to end me.
Blue flag dropped.
That didn't go so well, but
blue flag returned.
The YouTube channel playthrough is going perfectly excellent, and
red flag taken.
Like I said, we lost red two flag, main characters, three rookies. They didn't make it very far, which not bad.
Red flag taken. Red flag returned.
We just in XCOM, we just kind of progressed the story. We've lost a couple factions, as you would say, in world in the universe.
Yeah. Red flag taken.
Enemy flag carrier in the red.
Take that belt. Thank you for the shield belt.
Red flag drop. Red flag.
But I'm really, really enjoying it. Over the course of time, there's going to be changes to my YouTube channel. Like, I'm trying to get a friend of mine that's a really good artist that will really do my logo and my icon that you see in the upper right corners. Because I try to do like a
red flag taken.
Enemy flag carrier.
My own Photoshop of it, and it just
flag taken.
Just didn't turn out right. There's a lot of white missing pieces, and it looks utterly horrible.
Red flag returned.
I've got our flag.
But like the whole channel, it's all working in progress. I haven't really, a couple people asked me, why I don't edit my videos.
Rocket scientist.
I noticed at the last second I had 4 health. That was kind of crappy, and it is still just 0-0, so we're still pretty tied up.
Incoming!
I'm in position. Under heavy attack.
Red flag taken. Red flag. Red flag returned.
Don't you like my grip?
But I am having fun. A little update on scheduling wise. I've like conversed with my other job. And I mainly get Monday, anyone Tuesday, and Wednesdays off.
Red flag
so
taken.
Those days will be the day. Will be days that
red
I do the recording,
dropped.
Uploading. I know a lot of you
red
have been asking.
Taken.
The red base. Enemy flag.
They haven't texted me and messaged me saying, hey, you know,
red
one's next XCOM episode.
The flag carrier.
What about Far
red
Cry 4?
Taken.
I mainly worked thirds, but I was hired
red
in as a second shifter. And they kind of like flip flop me throughout the week between
I'm
both. Like, I'll work like
under
thirds and I'll work
red
I'll work a second
taken.
Shift, which second shift was 2-10 or 3-11. So
red
it's like I come
returned.
Home and
nail the flag carrier.
I tend to
blue
with the
taken.
On nights I work. If it's a third, if thirds I pretty much mainly damn it. I mainly sleep most
returned.
Of the day until I have to go to work, and like my second shift days I usually come home and spend time trying to work on new art for my channel. Like, all this is a learning thing for me. I'm not a very artistic kind of person. I'm just a gamer. So,
in position. I need some stamina.
For the fallen!
Red flag taken. So like I said, it's like the whole channel art, channel icon.
Red flag.
It's all a work in progress. They're gonna change. It's gonna look a little bit better. A lot of it looks kind of sloppy. I mean, it doesn't bother me too much because I really don't recognize or notice it unless I'm like when I'm trying to fix it.
In the red base. Red flag returned.
We're gonna
red
need flag help. Taken. I got 9 health and I'm gonna go try to take this fight. Health right here.
Red flag returned.
84.
In position.
But yeah, I. Like I said, I'm really enjoying doing the whole YouTube thing.
Red flag taken.
I mean, right now it's nothing really much.
Red flag
I would like it to become more. And the more people that subscribe and watch, returned. The better it will be.
Red flag returned.
Killing spree.
I do this all kind of backwards. And I got stuck again.
Ooh.
I thought I was gonna escape that. It's not looking so good for us right now. My XCOM Enemy Unknown is going really well. I'm really, really enjoying it. It looks amazing. It plays very smooth. It is challenging because you have to try and play safeguard on it and not try to push your units too far into it, or you attract the alien's attention. And like the mission that we lost, Gary, our heavy specialist.
That's gonna hurt.
Incoming.
They kind of like, in a lot of missions, they like in just inman mission, or each mission has like certain aliens
red
that are implanted in our for each mission,
taken.
But at the same
red
time, they like
returned.
To add enemies in the middle of mission. Like, that's how we lost Gary. They threw in a new enemy that I've not really seen yet, and they kind of just dropped three of them into the mission. We took out one of them, and then the other one kind of like got dropped right into, like, literally on top of Gary, and they're big beefy hard hitters. They hit him in like two shots. Whoa! Finally scored
in red base.
Damn
red flag.
Flag
returned.
In the red base.
Red flag taken.
Enemy flag here. In the red base. Get off me!
Red flag returned. Red flag
another
taken.
Another note on the channel. The things that have changed.
Red flag returned.
I don't know if anyone's noticed. I started doing the annotations. But the thing is I really, really dislike annotations. Like when I on like a lot of videos that I watch, they're not there right when the video starts, and then a little ways into the video. They kind of just pop up, and some of them are really, really big, like they'll like borderline the whole top, like quarter of the screen, and it just really, 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 really annoying. So therefore, I stopped doing them because besides the fact that they bother me and they annoy the little crap out of me, it's the fact that I'm. All these let's plays and all the videos I have them all in their I have them all in their own playlist, so to navigate between episodes is a lot easier.
Dominating.
Instead of just uploading video after video, I just shovel them all into a playlist for their particular. I'm doing all as a continuous series, so therefore I may do annotations at the beginning or at the end of like when I complete a series, like to, like the next series that we start, or specifically I'm gonna do genre based, like Far Cry 4 is an open world kind of survival kind of
incoming
kind of thing.
In position. I need some backup.
Red flag taken. Red flag returned.
So, so therefore, I'm not gonna add them except for like at the end of the series and like other videos. Like I was doing a subscribe thing, but it's kind of easy to navigate through my channel. But if you guys want me to do the annotations in every episode, I will do them. I'll leave that up to you guys. Like you can like vote on that in the comments.
Red flag returned.
Specifically,
red flag taken.
I've got our flag.
Videos like these monthly updates that I do. And by the way, if you guys
red flag
just be aware of the red flag returned updated episodes for like the monthly thing.
I've got our flag. Heading for the invisibility.
I'm gonna do them. I was gonna do them at the beginning of the month, but you know, doing them at the beginning of the month really is it like no time for doesn't really show any kind of like use otherwise. So therefore, I'm gonna do them at the end of the month. There's more stuff to cover in each episode.
In position. I need some backup.
I mean, besides those two games going on right now, and what's going on with the channel, I've thought deeply on the next series, and I probably won't do another series for a couple more weeks. Only for the fact is we haven't touched Far Cry 4 almost all entire month. The fact that I'm, like I said, I'm having major annoying issues with it.
Red flag taken.
There's more where that came from.
Red flag returned.
And it's very annoying. The fact that I can't figure out why. And usually I'm pretty good at this stuff.
Not push me.
Red flag.
I'm like so used to playing games. Games on very low settings because my previous computer is just shit. It was a PC I bought off a friend of mine for couple hundred bucks. Now I have this monster powerful machine.
Double kill. Killing spree.
Bringing it home.
Oh, really? I shot my own teammate, Jimmy. Oh, that was scary.
Heading for the invisibility.
Red flag returned. Red flag taken.
But a couple of ideas that I'm gonna throw out to you guys that I'm considered about doing as my next series is Fallout 4, of course. I kind of want to do that. I've been playing just a tiny bit of it. I really don't want to spoil it for myself. I'm kind of just around like checking out the new features and new skills. Like Fallout 4 is one of those games that's kind of hard for me to do blind because I've played previous Fallout games besides 1 and 2, because 1 and 2 is completely different than 3, New Vegas, and now 4.
Losing blood.
Red flag taken. Red flag returned.
And it's pretty much
red flag taken. Red flag taken. Red flag returned.
Double kill,
multi-kill. Oh,
killing spree.
Spots are a pain in the ass.
Blue flag.
Especially when you steal their flag.
Incoming.
Made in his image.
I'm just gonna forget. Have one of our.
Lo that I walk in the valley of.
Let's send Bishop out.
In position.
Team Bishop
are
gonna
kind of
tag team. No, wait a minute. What do we got? We got. There's. Wow, listen. I do that really? Oh, there's. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, there's 6.
Blue flag taken.
I kinda ran in this with no weapons. I'm gonna die right now. Yeah, that's true.
We shall cleanse this planet.
Blue flag returned. Red flag taken.
But as far as where we're at with... I can't even speak now. What subscribers? We are at 10 subscribers.
Red flag returned.
Which is very, very impressive. It's a lot more than I thought we'd have by the end of this month. And I thank you all for subscribing and keeping up with me.
Blue flag.
Feel free to, you know, show off my YouTube channel to people you know. Get more people added. The next milestone that I would like to hit is 100 subscribers. I mean, I want as many subscribers as I possibly can get. But once we hit 100 subscribers, I can customize my URLs. My URLs mean what? It's kind of hard when, like, a lot of people ask me, hey, you know, I hear you got a YouTube channel. What's your YouTube channel? And my standard URL that they give you is like randomly generated, and it's extremely long, and it's kind of hard to remember. So, therefore, once we hit 100 subscribers, I can edit that so it will just be my channel name.
Enemy flag carrier.
Red flag returned.
Incoming.
But at the moment, I'm kind of just doing this all for fun. Like, I would really like to make this
taken.
A career, and I've heard and read that you can do this as a professional.
Red flag returned.
Career-wise,
come on, I ain't just sticking around.
And it's one of the things
blue
I've been wanting
taken.
To do forever.
Red flag taken.
And if I can do it as a career, then I will.
You feel the impact of that one.
I'm all for it.
Red flag return.
But for me to be able to do this as a career, I need all your guys' help with subscriptions and watching all the videos. I know some of my videos can be very long and some of them may feel drawn out. And I'm doing the best I can to keep them in a matter that is a complete healing for all you guys. But
blue streak.
Got your back.
Incoming.
So yeah, like I said, feel free to, you know, show it off. Tell your friends and family about it. People that will actually watch it. And I know a lot of people I know go, oh, cool, you have a, you know, YouTube channel. I'll give you a subscription, but for it to really count, you guys need to. It really needs involvement from everybody, not just myself. Why? As in watching the videos and
red flag returned.
Good one.
Making comments.
Incoming.
I know I have a lot of my friends that like text me on Facebook, Messenger, on Steam, my cell phones, asking me questions about it.
Red flag drop. Red flag returned.
I would ask people not to do that. I mean, if you got questions on specific videos or, you know, character customization that I do per character, like in the XCOM Enemy Unknown, like how I have like all my friends as like custom
blue
characters
flag
in the
drop.
Game.
Blue flag returned. Blue flag taken.
Put them, do them comments on my channel. Either in the particular video or somewhere in the discussion. It's easier for me to maintain and not have to answer the same questions over and over. I know a lot of people are really, really shy on publicly making comments and concerns, especially on YouTube.
Red flag taken.
But I'm a really nice person, and I'm really good with, you know, with things. To me, there's no right or wrong comment, question. Specifically, if it's
red flag return.
If it's a question about any of the games that I'm doing on my channel or for myself.
Red flag taken.
Enemy flag carrier.
I mean, even if it's like a lot of people watch and go, oh, I think you did this this specifically thing in this specific enemy flag game really horrible and it's a really annoying, common it. Therefore, I could know how to better my gameplay for you guys that are watching.
Red flag taken.
You know, helpful tips are always
red flag.
Always are welcome.
Red flag returned. Red flag taken. Blue flag taken.
Come on, Bishop, let's run it. Let's run it, Bishop.
The red base. I'm taking heavy fire.
Where'd he go?
Flag carrier in the red base. Incoming.
Red flag returned.
Where are you going, Bishop? Come on, man. Don't go that way.
Blue flag returned.
Ah, you dick. I don't know why he was running all that way. Go ahead and grab this.
Killing spree.
Yeah, there we are right there.
Got your back.
Double kill. Multi-kill.
That's gotta hurt.
Come on. Oh, I'm stuck in the wall again. The only thing, a hard thing I don't like about Cash's life is I get stuck on shit. I've played all these maps so much that I do a lot of it backwards. And it kind of gets a pain, even though I've got all these levels memorized. It can be a pain in the ass. I'm gonna die. Ah, oh, bastard! Just when I turned around.
New flag taken.
I have a flag.
Woohoo! Thank you, Bishop, for the save on that one. Oh my god, that sucked. I was thoroughly thought we were going to die there. That was kind of opinion. But another thing on XCOM, I mean, known that I've recently, because I'm starting to have names, I want as many characters as possible, therefore we have several teams, so I'm not taking the same group of people in every mission. I like to have the roster and everyone ranked up, so I want to have like multiple squads to be able to go for missions. So if you want to have your own custom character, the only thing I ask for you guys is on specifically most recent episode, the current episodes available at the moment. Thank you.
Man down.
Leave me a name, specific color you want for your character.
For
I want to make every character unique, and I want
I'm
every character
red team scores
to be kind of like
5 minutes remain.
The same. I mean, there's only so many colors, so some characters may have to be the same. But I like to use everyone's favorite color to just make it more enjoyable for you guys. Like leave your first and last name, your favorite color, and if there's a class you want to use, you want as your character in.
Red flag returned. Blue flag taken.
I've got the flag.
In it, comment that as well. Therefore, I can, when that class comes available, become a customer who have a customized character.
Double kill.
They have to leave. I want them to leave to make them become rookie or squatty, because when they're rookie, they aren't generic. They're all generic. Regular class, they just carry an assault rifle, they don't have a specialty. As far as I know, so far, the classes for XCOM Enemy Unknown are sniper, assault, which assault is the close quarters shotgun, heavy, heavy carries a giant heavy machine gun, and rockets and grenades. Then there's
taken.
A support character. They carry
red flag drawn.
Support characters carry the standard assault rifle, and they are more of a support character, like they specialize in healing the other team, which I'm in dire need of support.
Incoming.
Really bad. We have one support character. And even though so far we're doing pretty good, we haven't really had to utilize her. But I can take her anyway. I take
red
her
flag
anyways.
Dropped. Three
just
minutes remain. Red flag returned. Blue flag taken.
Just for the fact is, since she's the only one, the higher rank she is, the better she is to be able to mobilize.
Red flag taken.
In each mission, so. But yeah, I really want to expand the squad. Have more support.
Red flag drop. Red flag returned.
I only have, like I said, I have like one support, one salt. I have, I think, 5 or 6 snipers and heavy classes. And we're getting to the point in the game where the fact is they're going to start sending us even more
red flag return
dangerous units. Like the new one that we just faced, I want to call them brutes, because they kind of remind me of brutes from Halo and several other games that have big giant ugly disgusting looking alien. He's massive, like he looks like a linebacker, a hardcore linebacker.
I've got our flag.
And I wouldn't be surprised if they utilize a
red flag return.
Some kind of rushing ability where
it's
run.
Blue flag taken.
I have the flag. I need backup.
Double kill. Multi kill. Dominating. Double kill. Multi kill.
Really, guys? You guys gonna fall for
this? Blue flag returned.
Okay, I should have stopped. Kept with them. That was kind of.
Blue flag.
Bug of a team player for me. Yeah.
Blue flag returned.
Death warrant in force.
And that minigun bears through you.
1 minute remains.
Ching. Got 50 seconds left of this episode going.
Red flag taken.
These multi episodes are kind of gonna be a little longer, that I'm gonna try not to make them as long, but they may just end up being
red
that
flag,
way just
red
the fact
flag returned.
That I want to make sure
I have the flag.
30 seconds left.
I can address all the matters that I have at the moment.
In position.
But
heading for the invisibility.
These episodes will range depending on
taken.
What's going on? What's upcoming?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
8-0. Woohoo! That was awesome. Our defense was kind of impenetrable, even though they kept taking the flag, but they weren't too far from it. That was really nice. But, one last moment for the LGDL episode. Upcoming events. I wanted to throw an idea to everybody. I have a bunch of... I'm not a big fan of indie games. And there's a lot of games that I have multiple CD keys for Steam stuff. And I want to throw an idea about doing some kind of giveaway. Like, do like a... Like, as an example, I'm not saying it has to be like this, but like Unreal Tournament. If a lot of you guys have Unreal Tournament, or there's a game, there's a, some game that we all have, like, together that we could all play, and I could just observe and kind of run through and just spectate you guys. If you guys want to do like some kind of like that, winning people. The people that win, what we could do several matches, do like a very small short match runs, multiple of them. I have a bunch of CD keys that I like to give out. But as far as the way I want to do it, I have a bunch of ideas, but I figure I throw out the idea to you guys and maybe we could come to some kind of agreement. I get these CD keys from like Humble Bundle. When I buy a bundle of something and they send me one, I get a bunch of CD keys of games that I'm not really interested in playing, if they're, I will post them in discussion on this episode after I upload it. And just so you guys can, like, look at the games and if there's anything that you guys are interested in, then we could all just kind of congregate again together and try to figure out a way that we could equally give everybody a chance to be able to gain free games. You know, who doesn't like free games? Oh, come on. But besides that, other upcoming events, next game I think I really want to cover is I want to do Dying Light. And Fallout 4 Dying Light, if for those of you who don't know what that is, that's the first person. It's by Techland, by the people that did Dead Island. It's kind of like a more polished, remake, I'd say, of Dead Island Riptide. I mean, Dead Island came out several years ago and I really liked it, but in my experience and be playing from the beginning, I didn't really like a lot of things they did it, and Dying Light kind of fixes a lot of the issues that Dead Island had, and plus they've added cool new features, like there's a whole parkour system that you can pretty much climb, run, jump from building to building, big giant ass parkour system that has a level up system. As you do it, you gain experience to level up and you can get skills. I would like to do that as a Let's Play series. Like I said before, Fallout 4 is another one, but Fallout 4 has got to be kind of difficult for me to do because I kind of get distracted in the Fallout universe, especially the new features they've added. Like, they added a building base kind of thing that I've been like, on my, the little that I've played of it, I've been experimenting with that and trying to get that flush in my mind, so when I do it on the channel, you guys don't have to sit a whole several episodes of me going over that and doing that. I mean, I'll go over it the first time, but that's, you know, when we get to that. But like I said, I want to fix my issues with Far Cry 4 and get Far Cry 4 going again, because we are halfway done with that, and that is almost finished in the story. Like I said, I have the two DLCs for that. XCOM Enemy Unknown, I can't really off the bat say how long that game is. That game seems like it's going to be a long haul, so. But I've been pushing out like 3 episodes. I'd say about 3 to 6 episodes every week now, just since I've started it. And those are quick, mission to mission, they're about 30 minutes. There's nothing left for me to really say for you guys today. Before I quickly sign off here, for those of you that are now just joining the channel, thank you for joining and subscribing. I really appreciate the support from all you guys. For more stuff for you guys to do for me, like I was saying early in the episode, leave me the comments. The comments help me big. I really would like to get everybody's input on all my episodes. I like you, like I said, I like you to refrain from like commenting and doing stuff in other social media ways of getting a hold of me on my channel. You guys, it would help me out a lot. But you guys are awesome. I thank you all for, you know, sticking with me. I'm gonna continue doing this. I'm really enjoying this and I'm having fun with it. But I think that is the end of this episode. So you guys all have a good one. I will see you all later. Have a good night.